This was Thursday night. And on Monday, I needed portraits to put on this wall. This is the story of how we set about finding Native American gingers. I was being hosted by JBU, John Brown University in Arkansas, and they were very kind in providing me with contacts and connections into the different communities in Oklahoma. So we're riding in Oklahoma City and we're going for the first portrait, but we've come first for fast food from our hospital. Best advice, use the toilet and eat when you can. It might seem like a slightly odd place to start a project about the United States, but it's at the centre, both geographically and historically, with the movement, the forced removal of Native communities off the land. We're here at the First Americans Museum to meet a couple of people. I had a lot to learn about the history of the place, but what appealed to me about Oklahoma was the fact that this is where many of the tribes were relocated to, and it was through their stories we could tell the story of the wider nation.
These are the Gardens of Eden, if you will, metaphorically speaking. Not only where the tribes originated, but also where they believe they came to be on Earth.
I want to show more of that interview in a future video because it's so fascinating, even just to get a glimpse of what has happened in these landscapes. But for us, we were on the move, we were trying to get to as many people as possible, and so we ended up in Ada, capital of the Chickasaw Nation, to meet a brother and sister. Got home late that night after some amazing junk food on the drive home, but the next morning we were straight out again, this time to Tulsa to meet some subjects. Normally I do a central space where people would come for the photographs, but in this occasion, with the constraints of Monday, we decided to go to the people. Amazingly, everything had gone to plan, and then I went outside on Monday morning.
How am I meant to go if you're...
Luckily, I knew a guy called Todd, formerly with the Delta Force. He had a 4x4 and he knew how to drive it.
So we made it in this morning and it's the final portraits. We've also got the exhibition tonight, so I'm hoping one of these will be in the exhibition. It's quite a tight turnaround, but that was the idea. It was a live making of work so the students could learn and see the process from beginning to end. Well, the beginning of the process is me generally in my office being tormented, but this is the actual process on the road. We've got Galena there. She's helping. She's been great. She's been putting up this backdrop and dropping it all the time. So well done her.
So this is the gallery space where we had the opening on Monday, and it's got previous gingers pictures, but we did it with blank work in progress. It's a work in progress. To see the process from being in the ground, meeting people, making the photographs and curating. So we had museum studies and photography students, just to show them the experience.
It's always a bit daunting when the subject appears at the opening. But Lakia was delighted with her portrait, as I was. I think next time I could even put more red into it because her hair is this most amazing colour.
But the local community turned out and they were just, it was so nice to be embraced and to think I've done it justice. And if I have, it's because of this man, Bobby Martin, local artist and professor at JBU. And that is part of the inspiration for making these videos, to show people what it takes to make a photograph. If you've got a suggestion of where I should go next for the Gingers of America, please leave your comments below. Like, subscribe, and share.